As of July 6th of 2025, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Hawaii's famed Kilauea volcano, which produced its 27th episode of activity involving 1,100-foot-high lava fountains on June 29th. This once-in-a-generation cyclical eruptive activity is still ongoing, and while the time in between cycles involves no lava effusion, we can expect episode 28 to begin sometime between July 7th and July 11th. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Japan, the alert level was raised at not only the nation's most active volcano, but the most active volcano in terms of the number of its recent eruptions in all of Asia, Mount Aso. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, a series of volcanic explosions threw lava bombs an unusually long distance at the Lewotolok volcano, resulting in its alert level also being raised. And, in what is this week's top story, Japan's Kirishima volcano produced a large explosion and eruption plume on July 3rd, causing ash to fall on numerous nearby communities. The specific eruption in question occurred at 1:49 p.m. local time on that day, when a volcanic explosion generated a sustained plume of ash that rose upwards to an altitude of 6,706 meters or 24,000 feet. As a result of the aforementioned plume drifting to the south-southwest, up to 2 millimeters of ash fell on surrounding towns, although most nearby areas only received a trace. Even Kagoshima received a few ash particles. This eruption continued for some time, and after it ended, it appears as though the two fissures generating the ongoing activity had further widened. Further eruptions occurred throughout the remainder of the week, involving weaker but hours-long sustained phreatomagmatic eruption plumes. However, apart from the ash being an annoyance, especially when driving on local roads, this eruption has so far thankfully not harmed anyone. Heading over to Indonesia, specifically on the island of Lembata, the Lewotolok volcano produced a series of unusually strong Strombolian explosions this week. Events of particular note occurred on June 29th and June 30th, but the most powerful series of events occurred on July 3rd. These ejected various sized bombs of lava up to 1,500 meters away from the erupting vent, primarily to the north and northeast. These lava bombs caused several wildfires to start as the molten rock ignited areas with thicker vegetation. Due to the potential for more similarly energetic events regarding Lewotolok's eruption, which began in January of this year, its alert level was raised from 2 to 3, and a 3-kilometer exclusion zone was implemented around it in all directions. Heading back to Japan, the nation's most active volcano in the last 200 years since it erupted at some point during 104 of those years is Mount Aso, located on the island of Kyushu. Despite being located within a vast caldera, the partially formed in a super eruption approximately 87,000 years ago, its recent eruptions in historical times have been mostly only small or moderate in size. Most of these recent eruptions have originated from its Nakedake crater, which generally produces phreatic or volcanic explosions, the last of which occurred in 2021. However, since midday on July 4th, the strength of volcanic tremor indicating either fluid or magma movement, probably the former, has notably increased and remained high ever since. As a result, there is now a potential, in my opinion, that sufficient pressure exists to trigger a somewhat unexpected phreatic eruption. As a result, Aso's alert level was raised from 1 to 2, and a 1-kilometer exclusion zone was declared in all directions around its Nakadake crater. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on July 5th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, SF Barnes, for supporting my work.